This video is sponsored by Parallels. Something I had to do back in my IT days was I had to install Windows and various different distros of Linux on my work Macs. Now, the problem with installing Windows or even Linux on modern Macs is ever since Apple did the Apple Silicon transition over to ARM, Bootcamp, which was Apple's native solution for installing Windows or other OSs on a Mac, no longer works. Now, this can be a real problem if you need a Windows application for your work or even want to play games on your Mac, but this is where Parallels comes in. Parallels is an application that allows you to run virtual machines, also known as VMs, on top of Mac OS. What's great about this compared to something like Bootcamp is you don't have to shut down Mac OS to use it. It's just another window running on top. Now, the setup of this is extremely easy. I've installed Windows on a lot of machines, and it has never been easier than this. To get started, download Parallels using the link in the description below. Parallels will handle downloading Windows and installing it for you. No need to go and get an ISO file of Windows and then mount it to some thumb drive you have laying around. You don't have to do any of that. It takes all the annoying bits of having to install Windows on another machine and it just handles it for you. It also handles installing all the drivers you need for you. So no need to search a sketchy forum for some random Bluetooth driver that probably has malware running in it as well. I was up and running with Windows on my Mac within 20 minutes. Now, there are a bunch of different ways you can run Windows on a Mac, but Parallels is extremely well thought out. Even after the initial setup process, they still go above and beyond. For example, keyboard shortcuts like cut, copy, and paste still use the command key. Now, traditionally with Windows, that would be Control-C, Control-X, and Control-V, but Parallels handles remapping these keyboard shortcuts and a bunch of others automatically for you so you don't break your muscle memory. If you copy something, say a string of text or a password from Mac OS, it then passes it over to the Windows VM so you can paste it in Windows. Windows, the OS, is really just another application window running on top of Mac OS. Parallels does a great job of bridging the gap between the two. You can also make the VM full screen so it looks like you're just running natively on that hardware, or you can run it in a window mode so you can interact with both OSs at once. Parallels also handles setting aside and dealing with drive space. So what's nice about this is you no longer have to partition your drive. So when you set this up, you're like, I guess I'll give it 400 gigs, but do I really want to take away 400 gigs from Mac OS? You don't have to worry about that. In fact, you can dynamically shift how much storage your VM has in the settings. So there's no need to rebuild Windows every single time you run out of drive space now. You can even tweak how much RAM and CPU cores your VM has access to as well. Now, this can be really important to balance out if you still plan on doing really heavy tasks on Mac OS while you have Parallels and Windows running. Overall, Windows runs extremely smoothly on top of Mac OS. I'm running this on a normal everyday M4 Pro Mac Mini. This isn't the top of the line Mac by far, and it's actually not even the top of the line M4 Pro Mac Mini. When using Parallels on the Mac, you manage everything from Control Center. Here you can launch or suspend your VMs, change settings per virtual machine like storage management, folder sharing with host, a productivity or gaming mode. You can even enable a travel mode so the VM uses less data. Mac OS doesn't even have that. There is a lot you can tweak in here. Now, nobody, and I can't underscore nobody enough, should buy a Mac for gaming. The library just isn't there. Like, you can go to the App Store or even Steam for Mac OS, and there just isn't a whole lot there. But if you have access to Windows, that kind of changes things. So I did a little gaming in Windows while running in a VM. I loaded up one of my all-time favorite games, Mass Effect 2. This is from the Remastered Legendary Collection. It played really smoothly. I played through the first few missions and didn't have any issues. I got a solid 40-ish frames per second frame rate. I did go in and give it access to as much of the CPU cores as I could, and I also bumped up the RAM to 36 gigabytes. I paired an Xbox controller to Mac OS and Parallels passed it right over to Windows. I suck at playing games with a keyboard and mouse, so this was a must for me. It worked great, and I didn't notice any latency. I also loaded up Borderlands 3. This game was a bit too much for my poor Mac Mini. It was playable, but very choppy. But if you were to have a beefier Mac, it should play just fine. Indie games like Dead Cells, Stardew Valley, or Hades, those stuff that aren't really graphic intensive, they're gonna play fantastic here. If you already have a Mac, this could be like the perfect like indie gaming machine. At the end of the day, Macs aren't really designed to play games, but depending on what Mac you have, you can play some heavy, beefy games. Or if you're like me and you like the indie games like Dead Cells or Hades or Stardew Valley, you can get really good performance out of that, and you can play some of the really best all-time indie games right on your Mac. Now, you can also use Parallels to install Linux as well. This was something I had to do a lot back in my IT days as well. When you go into Parallels Control Center, there is a plus button. Use this to install another VM. There are a few different built-in Linux options right here. I installed Kali Linux out of nostalgia. Kali Linux is designed for pen testing networks, something I used to have to do a lot. I have no need for it anymore, but it was fun to play around with again. And like Windows, it ran smooth as butter. Whether you're looking to have Windows running on your Mac for productivity reasons, you need access to certain work applications or whatever, or if you're wanting to play games, Parallels is the best experience I have ever had running Windows on the Mac. The setup process is super easy, especially something compared to boot camp from a few years ago. Like I said, I was up and running within 20 minutes. And you don't need to be an IT expert to do it. You don't really need to do any tweaking. Parallels handles it all for you. Now, they do give you the options if you want to go in there and you want to tweak it to be the exact performance that you want, or you want to give it extra resources or anything like that. You absolutely can go in and do that, but you don't have to. If you need access to Windows or even Linux on your Mac, Parallels is the best way to do it. I'm going to put some links in the description below so you can go check out Parallels. Thank you all so much for watching the video. If you like the video, hit the thumbs up button, subscribe if you haven't already, and have a great day.